On the third day of the 5-day hunt, we located a beautiful 30-inch plus buck. We glassed a big deer until he finally bedded in a small patch of thick vegetation. Now we could only wait until he arose from his bed. Often these waits can be 3 to 4 hours. Time has proven this is a far superior method than spooking the deer from its bed, forcing a long shot on a running animal. The patient hunter is the successful hunter.
Shoot again. Behind that bush. There he is. Down. What do you think, Tim?
That was great. I love those long shots.
300 yarder, huh?
Yeah. Right in the pocket. That was nice the way he kind of come out of the cover and died right in the open for us.
There he is, Tim.
Whoa! Ho,
ho. What a buck, huh?
Yeah! That's a dandy. Woo! Yeah! Thank you. Alright, look at that thing. Oh, man.
Look at the mass.
Oh, yeah. Woo!
All of those beans.
Oh, yeah.
Beans are long as heck.
Yeah, look at them. That's a nice deer.
Oh. Big bodied buck.
Oh, yeah.
Phil and Sandy missed this buck this morning and...
Oh, they're gonna be crying.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
What a stud.
Yeah,
deer.
We waited a long time for him to get up.
Yep.
Then he got up. I was afraid he was going to bed again. I thought he was just going to change positions and bed back in that thick brush. We got lucky. He decided to come in here maybe for a little drink of water or something. Huh?
Yep. Woo-hoo. He's got to be over 30.
Oh, man. Don't even say that.
He's got
Don't even say that.
Well, Tim, what do you think? Oh, I think he's dandy.
We taped him. He's 31 and a half inches wide. He's got 26 beams. He's 27 inside. So
he's a nice buck.
The biggest buck ever?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Biggest buck. It was great, too. I got to make a nice long shot out of it. It makes it even better.
Tell us about the stock.
Oh, we crept down. I timed it. We left the top of the ridge. It was an hour. We got down into position. We had him bedded, and we had to wait. Wait, play the waiting game for him to get up. Every now and then he'd twitch his tail a little, and then I would start to get impatient. Doyle looked at his watch. He goes, I guarantee you he'll be up in 5 minutes. 3 minutes later, he came up. Just had to wait for him to come clear. And he came clear, and we made the shot. No ground shrinkage on this one.
No, he's a dandy pup.
After the meat has been packed out from the mountain, guide Stan Hansard brings out the last load, the antlers, and Tim Davey has a trophy of a lifetime.